In this illustration, we'll study about a situation for holding two halves of a shell. Here it is saying, a uniformly charged shell of charge plus Q is cut in two halves as shown in the figure, and we are required to find the magnitude of a point negative charge which is to be placed at the center of shell so that two halves will not separate. Here we are given that the shell is charged plus Q, so on the two shells, charge will be Q by 2 and Q by 2. And we are required to find the value of this charge which is placed at center so that these two will not separate. So obviously this charge must be negative so that it will attract the two, which will balance the repulsive force between the two halves, which we have calculated in another illustration earlier also. So here we can see, for holding the two halves of shell, total electric pressure on surface of shell should be zero. Because due to the own charge, the shells are applying an outward electric pressure, and this negative charge placed at center will apply an inward pressure. If the two pressures will balance out, these shells will not experience any force due to which these can be separated. So here we can write here, electric pressure outward must be equals to electric pressure inward. This outward electric pressure is due to its own charge, which we already studied, given by sigma square by 2 epsilon naught. And for the inward electric pressure, it is due to the electric field by this minus Q. So it can be written as sigma multiplied by the perpendicular electric field on it. If you want to go through all these concepts once again, I suggest you to go through the conceptual videos, how we have calculated these pressures, so that there should not be any knowledge gap here. And here the charge density sigma for the shell we can write as Q by 4 pi r square, and the perpendicular electric field due to this minus Q charge on the surface of the shell can be written as KQ by r square. These we already studied. So if we substitute these values over here, you can see what we are getting. This Q by 4 pi r square whole square by 2 epsilon naught is equals to sigma, which is, I just write the value of sigma, it is Q by 4 pi r square multiplied by electric field in normal direction is KQ by r square. Here this Q by 4 pi r square will cancel by this square, and here the value we are getting is Q by 8 pi epsilon naught r square is equals to, here k we can write as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught multiplied by q by r square. So here this pi epsilon naught also gets cancelled out, this r square also gets cancelled out, and this 4 will also be cancelled out. So we are getting the charge q is equals to capital Q by 2 in magnitude. That is the answer to this problem. And this is the magnitude, and we already discussed it should be negative for the pressure to be in inward direction. So we'll put a negative sign, and just to complete it, that the charge required is a negative charge.